My name is Brian Omolo and I'm a graphic artist and an illustrator based in Nairobi, Kenya. My life of art started way back, even from the time I was a kid. I just used to pause cartoons and then sketch. It wasn't until I grew up that I realized that it's actually a big deal. From the reaction I was getting from people, you could tell this was something more, something to sort of expound on. Later on, that's when I started thinking about graphic design and this computer graphics and branding. So just trying to marry that artistic taste with the commercial side of graphic design and just trying to play around with the two of them and see what I come up with. The idea behind Vongozi was I wanted to do something that was inspired by the presidential aspirants. I wanted to do artworks that it's relatable to all Kenyans. So if I was to do an artwork on them, everyone would sort of have their reaction to it and everyone would be sort of have an opinion about the work. Everyone will experience it in some way or another. And I think I also pushed myself a bit further because I put more graphics into the portraits. And I think the style comes out well and I'm happy with the reaction I'm getting so far. I just have to work hard, man. You have to work hard, you have to be passionate about what you're doing. Like, passion is number one, it's key. You have to also be true to yourself and you pick up other wisdom around the way. But if the passion isn't there, it's very visible. Like, if the passion is not there, you're just wasting people's time. Move from something else. There are easier ways to make money. I get a lot more money from freelance jobs than the money I've been getting from the art. The art just sort of attracts people and then they give me work. They sort of say, oh, I saw something you did and I liked it. I want you to do this. So it's drawing people in like that. But I wanted to come to a point where maybe people buy my work or people commission me to do for them something. It sort of looks like my style of work. So that the two will start marrying themselves together, start making money. Some of the other projects I've done, they get attention from all over, but because I've been using the internet, I have most of my portfolio online, so I get comments from anyone, all over. Yeah. But I think it's something that's more common, I would say, in the West. You see people doing artworks like that for commissions all the time. I think the most embarrassing times are when I'm late for something. Yeah, I'm that guy. The guy who's walk into class like half an hour, it's already started. And the one who's running last minute to try and hand in assignments or like just in time before something is happening or something. So yeah, but trying to change it now, but yeah. Just chilling the pals, just chilling the boys, brothers, cousins, kids, okay. So whenever we're around each other, we're always like the same. The sports going out and that kind of thing. There's a guy who contacted me, this artist from TZ, he's called David. Yeah, he's a cool guy. Like, he just called me, he told me, you just do your thing, have fun. Like, he just called me 2 weeks later to see if the job comes out. So that kind of creative freedom is, it's always good. I enjoy doing that project. And also, like, there are a few projects I did when I was in university. There's some concept art for a Facebook game. The game never actually came out, but there was that kind of aha moment, like you're walking into an office about to do a Facebook game and you're like, wow, like these are things you think about when you're a kid, and then now it's actually happening. So I think, yeah, those two projects are pretty good.